Dr Muffazal Lakdawala, I'm the chairman of the Institute of Minimal Access Lifestyle Sciences in Sefi Hospital, Mumbai, and Professor Emeritus at BYL Hospital, Nair Hospital, Topiwala National Institute in Mumbai. I'm also the director of Digestive Health Institute in Mumbai. Obesity is a trending word wherever you go. If you were to hashtag obesity, you'll get enough and more answers. But today, obesity has become a lifestyle disease. Obesity is the number one cause for most illnesses, be it health-wise, be it physical illnesses like type 2 diabetes, hypertension, sleep apnea, infertility, various types of cancers are linked to obesity, as well as psychosocial. Today, obesity is the number one cause for relationships not working out. It is the number one cause for not getting jobs. It is the number one cause also for someone going into depression. Today, childhood obesity is getting bigger and bigger because children are getting affected. So we really need to take serious steps towards preventing obesity. Like I said, obesity impacts all forms of life, and definitely in sports. The only sport I can think of where obesity can be a plus is probably in sumo wrestling. Otherwise, all other forms, obesity is not something that is going to help you at all. Most athletes are fit. They don't even come close to having fatness levels of most normal people. Unfortunately, once they get rid of their athletic careers, they go on to put on so much weight. And so we need to understand, why is it that only during the career lifespan of an athlete that he is fit? Fitness should be a way of life, not just for a reason or for a season. Obesity today is causing a lot of expenditure in terms of not only health issues, so it's causing world over, the GDPs and the health budgets of governments across the world are getting affected. India stands number three in terms of the number of obese people in the world, and number two in terms of the type 2 diabetes burden. So when we have less than 1% of our GDP being devoted to health, it's not a really good thing. Budgets of the US, where there's a lot which has been put from the GDP budget into the healthcare, they also struggle. They say that every 1 second there is a life dying out of type 2 diabetes related health, and obesity today is causing more economic downturns across the world, not only because of the number of man loss hours because of the illnesses it produces, but also because of the amount of money that is being spent, not only to research obesity, but also to try and battle it on a personal front. Most of the times when you are just overweight, you need to exercise, you need to watch what you eat. So lifestyle changes are a must. But when you're morbidly obese and when you're type 2 diabetic, or when you're struggling with sleep apnea and various other dreaded illnesses that obesity brings along with it, then probably bariatric surgery or metabolic surgery is the only answer. Very often we blame our hormones, like the thyroid is very often blamed, or the adrenal gland hormone, or our genetics. Please understand that 95% of the causes of obesity are directly linked to lifestyle and how we respond to our lifestyle. Lack of sleep, the increased stress levels that are associated with modern lifestyles, and the changing lifestyles. So Indians have adapted to a Western lifestyle. The outdoor games and the outdoor programs have become lesser and lesser. And things which were at one point of time a luxury, like elevators and air conditioners and cars, have now become a necessity. So we hardly have time to go out and do physical activities. We hardly have time for ourselves, and we hardly have time to get out of the sedentary behavior that we've got so used to. Endoscopy is coming in a big way in the field of bariatric surgery. We've got newer procedures like the endoscopic sleeve gastrectomy or robotic advances in bariatric surgery. But the procedures kind of remain the same. The gastric bypass remains one of the top procedures, though the sleeve gastrectomy is taking over it in terms of the number of procedures. But of course, you see that drop again. So I believe that the procedures are more or less the same. It's just endoscopic techniques of doing newer procedures. There's also combined therapies, like in cancer therapy, where we had chemotherapy, radiation, along with surgery. Today, I think in the field of obesity-related type 2 diabetes, there's a concept of interventional diabetology coming in, wherein surgery might play a role, along with some of the newer drugs that are available, or endoscopy might play a role along with some of the newer drugs, and that's where obesity is going today. I think despite all the latest advances in the field of obesity medicine or in surgery, we fail to act on one thing. We fail to convince our government that obesity is a disease. We fail to convince the insurance companies that they rather pay for obesity today and the treatment of obesity rather than paying for the ill effects of obesity years down the line. So if we want to change policy, the action should come from the government. The action should come from public health awareness groups. The action should come from people demanding that obesity be included as a disease. India today is not only a great destination in terms of medical health, but it's also a relatively cheap destination when you're looking at a medical solution. So it's not only got skill, it's got class, but it also comes at a much lower price than some of the Western world. So India becomes a very attractive tourist destination in terms of medical tourism. In terms of bariatric medical tourism, well, majority of our medical tourism comes from the Gulf. It comes from African nations, it comes from Iraq, it comes from Afghanistan and various other places of Middle East and Africa.